Janine Marcinot and Michel Prokopow's 2012 Nuit Blanche exhibit, Museum for the End of the World, was staged in and around Toronto City Hall's underground parking garage. An exhibition of 14 artworks, a perfect addition to 2012's theme of apocalypse. A revolving satellite of garbage spun in space. Discarded tech manifested into a white dwarf, a dying star whose energy implodes into degenerate matter. On the other side of the chamber was an exhibition of Kodachrome film, some of the last Kodachrome film shot. I'm confronted by the fact that in my time, film has already become obsolete. From film to digital dreams. At a time when all the bike lanes are being cremated by Rob Ford, Tania Mouraud's Once Upon a Time was a fitting testimony of the destruction of the rainforest projected onto the side of City Hall. There was a huge crowd outside of Douglas Coupland's Museum of the Rapture, waiting expectantly to be herded by the police through the gates down into the parking garage. This was Museum for the End of the World, so it was fitting everybody needed a picture of it.
It's totally zombies Rapture in the world.
Frenzied fear and expectations of the apocalypse, Douglas Coupland's sign saying, "It's not the end," was pretty funny. And there was a crashed car like a smoking gun. People walked around it looking for the victims that were already gone. Zombies had taken over the parking lot. Remnants of their carnivorous meal, shopping carts and meat, lay in piles. People circled the perimeter, taking pictures of the grim scene. Floyd's The Wall is good preparation for this exhibit. Gives new meaning to Sausage Factory. Have yourself a merry Mayan apocalypse. Blanchard's The Vault featured subterranean glowing frozen capsules of seeds and suspended floating roots, photo lightbox installations, archives for a new future, the seed banks for tomorrow. This is what happens when you build a refuge from the apocalypse in an underground parking garage. Paved hell to while away the last of your days. Quasars are massive star incubators in the center of far-off galaxies. interacting immense energy magnetically erupts against colossal black holes. This interactive sound and light sculpture celebrates the birth of new stars, a reflection of renewing and evolving life cycles, fluctuating and changing. The Acid House Party 416-788-9663 could be heard before it was seen. Drawing you over to the obscure City Hall alley where Dayglow Club kids danced and pranced, emulating the Toronto Underground dance party scene, circa 1994. Six orbs illuminate Nathan Phillips Square, with film and photo projections inspired by Jacques Cousteau's films of the ocean, vast nebula, and minute brain cells. Universes of multiple interconnected environments on the brink of oblivion and renewal. Museum for End of the World contemplates the destruction of the apocalypse with glimpses through the gloom of a different future as what it could be.